Lee Soo-man sells all his remaining SM Entertainment shares to HYBE.
LOL. Do y'all get what's happening here? If Bang PD is the Elon Musk of K-pop, then HYBE is most definitely the Disney Corporation of the industry. They're trying to be the next Universal, Sony, and Warner Music, efficiently and quickly rising in ranks of market capital value. From a neutral standpoint, I will say that I despise monopolies and don't think anyone conglomerate should have absolute control over a specific market or industry. But from an army's completely biased standpoint, I'm not even slightly joking when I say I laughed at this news for a solid 8 minutes. And even hours later, as I edit this video, I'm busting a fucking gut because HYBE and SM company stans hate each other. Personally, as a K-pop fan who's not a company stan, I love groups under both companies. I'm excited. Because of this, there will very likely be a joint HYBE x SM project and I would just fall out and die if the strongest aspects of both companies were brought together to make an amazing group. However, I'm still quite the petty individual, and this has a deliciously humorous trickle-down effect that I don't think enough people are clocking. Everything Lee Soo-man was getting money for out of SM, his artists, his ideas, and his contributions is now going to HYBE. And you know each BTS member owns millions of dollars worth of HYBE stock, right? So every time an SM stan who shitted on BTS for years because they felt like their faves deserved the success BTS has, streams a song or buys merch for an SM artist that Lee Soo-man used to get paid for is now going into HYBE and essentially the BTS members' pockets. And as an army, there's just something so satisfying, damn near maliciously, about knowing that BTS are even slightly receiving money off of your fave's name and your fave's work. And from a business perspective, HYBE exists because of BTS, so it's completely fair for them to get paid this way. L-O fucking L.
Le Sserafim all wore crocheted tops and accessories made by Sakura on M Countdown. Unfortunately, she's getting criticized for her singing during the encore.
Sometimes Yeonjin wrecks me, but I am essentially a Sakura solo fan. I don't feel the need to delude myself of the fact or even avoid the fact that Sakura is not the best singer. But at the same time, I'm not one of those many people who act like you need to excel at something to pursue a career in it, especially when it comes to entertainment and the arts. I think it's perfectly fine not to be a good singer, as long as you make good music and don't overinflate your own abilities, which she doesn't. On top of the fact that I think her specific contributions to Le Sserafim are her star quality, performance ability, and chameleon-like concept adaptability, which I think she has the most of out of her other members. There are three very weak singers in Le Sserafim. That's literally half of them. When groups are more performance-based than vocal-based, I wish they spared each other the embarrassment and got creative with their encore stages. Like maybe singing the whole song together, so no individual person would be singled out, or doing like BTS often did and making it a fun celebration instead of vocal vulture bait, because this is embarrassing and has got to be damaging to idols' already fragile self-image.
Hyuri says she's against idols like Jennie and NewJeans wearing revealing clothes. It's good that she's caring, but some fans think it's strange to group Jennie, who is a fully grown adult, with NewJeans. Jennie's new campaign with Calvin Klein goes viral, as always.
I don't think Hyori was grouping NewJeans with Jennie. She was just referring to them at the same time, which isn't the same thing. I don't believe Hyori is confused about the fact that NewJeans are a group of minors and Jennie is a damn near 30-year-old woman. I've defended Jennie many times for her wardrobe choices, because she has the right to choose. Grown women should wear whatever they want to without fear of ridicule. That's actually the exact thing I commended her for in my Praising Women in Music Part 2 video. NewJeans, on the other hand, are a completely different story, because they're so young. Even the members who aren't legally minors are not categorically grown like Jennie is. To this day, I'm very put off by Haiyan at 14, essentially wearing a bra in the music video for attention. Some of you may think it's not a big deal, and it may not be. But when you take into consideration that in Korea it's risque for even adult women to wear off-the-shoulder tops, I'm sure you can only imagine how that's seen for a child to be wearing what looks like a spaghetti strap bra for a shirt, even if they are an idol that doesn't change social views. And I think Hyori was coming from a place of concern. Being 17 and 28 years their senior, especially in the music industry, it's always protect female idols until someone speaks up, then it's nitpicking.
Dispatch revealed Aespa's Karina and actor Lee Jae-wook are dating. The two met at the Prada fashion show on January 14, SM stated. They are only now getting to know each other. Some fans are happy she's dating someone close to her age, some remain delulu saying Karina's for the girls, and others are crying. Hopefully Dispatch didn't ruin a new couple.
As a member of the LGBTQ+ community myself, I understand the want for the people you admire to have social irregularities similar to you, because it makes you feel good when people with a platform and people with an influence are like you in some way. But all the people who are genuinely hurt or surprised that Karina is dating a man should take this as a lesson, not to project sexuality onto people. I'm not talking about a relatively innocent joke about sexuality. I'm talking about the people who heard the news and are honestly shocked because, in my opinion, Karina has never ever genuinely given off a rainbow girl vibe. Y'all just wanted her to. No, you cannot assume someone's sexuality, but there are hints that are far more believable than calling a female friend a girlfriend. Karina could possibly like girls as well, but she's never really given an indication that she did, so none of you should be surprised.
Le Sserafim's Yunxin will feature on J-Hope's upcoming song I Don't Know.
Good for Yunxin, really, that's great for her. I just wish I liked the song, because I am going to feel like any collaboration that J-Hope does and I don't like it is a waste of a feature he could have had with Tinashe that I've been manifesting for years now. He already snagged J. Cole. Next let it be Tinashe, one of the few artists I think can keep up with him both musically and dance-wise.
To make you suffer, thought we left one another, cause of all my old lovers around. Be quiet, don't make a sound, cause all my girls like to fall.